And now we will learn about this type of transaction, receiving payments for past invoices. There are several different types of payments that we can receive for invoices that customers owe us. However, in this video, we will receive exact payments. That means we are receiving payments that are the exact amount of an invoice. For example, we received payment in example one of an exact amount of an invoice. January 19th, we received $2,240 from Candy for invoice number 8. She gave us check number 1234, and in this example, the amount of Candy's check is exactly the amount of the invoice that she is paying for. When we look at our customer report, the customer balance detail, we see each of the previous invoices made the balance go up after each one was recorded. However, if we record a payment, we know that the balance will decrease. The payment we are recording is January 19th, so we know that the payment we record will be listed at the bottom of this report because this report shows the transactions in date order. After the minus to the balance is recorded from the payment window, QuickBooks will recalculate the new balance of Candy, which will be lower as a result of the payment. This report is very helpful because it shows all the transactions that affect the customer's balance, and as you can see, it puts it in date order. However, there is another important question. After the payment, how do we know which specific invoices are still unpaid? We cannot know that by looking at the customer balance detail. We cannot assume that this payment was applied to this invoice just because it's the same amount. So how do we know the answer to this question? Well, the answer is we need another report. We need another report that shows us only the invoices that are unpaid. And we refer to the unpaid invoices as open invoices. So, the name of the report that shows only what remains unpaid is called the Open Invoice Report. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Reports, Customers and Receivables, and Open Invoice. Now, we have to modify the report in the way that we learned before. Always make sure that you change the date range to all. You can do this, by the way, by simply pushing the letter A on your keyboard. We also learned in previous videos how to remove the columns that we're not using. The purchase order number column is not relevant to us. Let's move the mouse to the top right of the purchase order column, click and drag to the left to remove that column. We're also not using the terms column yet. So let's move the mouse to the top right, click and drag to the left, and remove the terms column. We can even make the whole report a little bit thinner. When we look at the section of Candy, we see that the invoices are still here because we have not received payment. All of Candy's invoices are still open. And before we record the payment, let's add it to the icon bar. When the Open Invoice window is the active window, click View, and then click Add Open Invoice to the icon bar, and then we will click OK. Now we can use it more easily and open it and see it more quickly. Let's just remind ourselves what the transaction is. January 19th, received $2,240. From Candy for invoice number 8, and she gave us check number 1234. So what will happen in the Candy section of Open Invoice when we record the payment? Well, if the payment is an exact amount of invoice number 8, that means that invoice number 8 is going to completely disappear from the Open Invoice report. And when we finish recording the payment, Candy will be left with 4 invoices rather than 5. From the main menu, click Customers, Receive Payment. And the Receive Payment window opens up. I like to collapse the ribbons so I don't get distracted. We received, well, first let's put in the date, January 19. Okay, now, let's put in the payment method, check number 1234. Now, look what happens when we choose the customer. Received from Candy. As soon as we choose Candy, all of Candy's open invoices appear in the center panel in the body of this window. And the last piece of information we will put is the money amount. The money amount is $2,240. So just type in the digits without a comma or a decimal point or a dollar sign. After typing in only the digits, look very carefully what will happen on the screen when I push the tab key. Aha! When I push the tab key, QuickBooks put a check mark next to invoice number 8. QuickBooks knew we were paying invoice number 8 because it's the only one with an exact match as the amount of the payment. So whenever you put in a payment amount, the very first thing QuickBooks will do is check if there's an exact match. And if there is, then QuickBooks will put the check mark in the margin and assume that's the one you're paying for. When we click Save and Close, we notice the open invoice changes immediately and we only have 4 open invoices for Candy. I also promised you that Candy's balance would become $9,460. When we take a look at the customer balance detail for Candy, we can see that the payment is listed here on the bottom, and QuickBooks lowered the balance to $9,460. And one final note, can you predict what accounts in the trial balance will change when we receive payments for a previous invoice? That's right. The invoices are listed as a plus to account receivable, and therefore account receivable will go down when we receive a payment from a customer. What else will change? Well, if we physically received money that is not yet in the bank, it goes into undeposited funds, and of course we have more undeposited funds as a result. I will close out my other reports and I will open the trial balance. And of course, in the trial balance, accounts receivable is slightly lower. When I double click my account receivable and look at the very bottom, the very last transaction on the 19th is a payment, making the balance go down, and it's recorded in the credit column, which means it is a minus to the account. When I look at undeposited funds, I can double-click the balance, and when I look at the bottom, the last transaction is that same payment we just made, and of course, that's listed as a positive amount, making the balance of undeposited funds go up.